It is the most exciting story, and I know you agree with me that there's no story better than this story, because this must be the story, because the story focuses on the birth, the life, the death, the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And of course, we have not left our theme. It is the undisputed, undefeated champion of love. Who else would you need to be champion of your love in your life? It is the man Jesus Christ, the man who hung upon the old rugged cross, that you and I might have the eternal life that we have today. So the story is worth listening to, and the story is worth telling, the story of Jesus. Yes, we are now talking about the miracles of Jesus, and we have ventured into the nature stories, the nature miracles, where Jesus and nature combine to tell the world that Jesus is in the business of saving souls. Well, this one is probably the most exciting and the most interesting nature story to me, and I hope to you too also, because this setting was so exciting when the disciples were in the boat alone, as they were traversing the waters, forgetting what Jesus had done in the past, quieting the storms. And as Jesus was coming to them after he was praying, well, I know most of us struggle with this part of our life. I think we call it the state of the dead, where we don't understand what is happening in the other realms. When they saw Jesus coming towards them, they thought, well, it was a ghost, but it was not a ghost. It was actually Jesus himself. Probably their vision was blurred, but Jesus was coming to the rescue of his disciples. And the disciples didn't realize that it was Christ. And they were terrified with fear, because they actually thought it was a ghost. But Jesus revealed himself like he always does. Well, I hope Jesus will reveal himself to you in your life today, and that you might see him clearly, that you might love him dearly, that you might follow him nearly, because that was Jesus would desire from us. After Jesus revealed himself to them, well, they kind of realized that, no man, this is not a ghost. This is the undefeated, undisputed champion of love, our master, our Lord and Savior, the one whom we follow, the man Jesus Christ. But of course, in the boat, there was one guy. I love this guy because, well, his character, probably, I think I'm imagining that I might be closer to Peter because I think I'm an extrovert. I think I'm a sanguine. But this guy could not just wait for Jesus to get into the boat. He said, Jesus, is that really you? And Jesus says, yes, this is me. And Jesus was walking on water. Well, for those who study the Bible, well, I don't normally do this, but for those who study, I like this story. That's why I'm telling you this. For those who study the Bible, the word Jesus was walking on water was called parapatel. So tell your friends every other time that I know a Greek word, parapatel. Jesus was parapateling on the water. He was walking on the water. So Peter said to Jesus, well, my master, if it is really you, please command me to also walk on water. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. That's why I love Peter. Peter is so exciting. He makes even the stories of the life of Jesus become so wonderful. And actually, Peter got outside the boat as the other 11 disciples were watching on Peter. And Peter started walking on water. As he was walking on water, let me remind you, with men, some things are impossible. But with God, all things are possible. The possibility of Peter parapateling on the water, just as Jesus was doing, was because he had faith in the undisputed, undefeated champion of love. As Peter was walking on water, going towards where Jesus was, I think he got excited and he probably turned to his friends. Well, I don't know whether he waved, whatever it is, but he removed his focus from Jesus. And because of the pride, he started to sink in the water. Sometimes it happens to us in our lives. When we are walking with Jesus, when Jesus has commanded us to come, sometimes we don't focus on Jesus. We look at the excitement of the things around us and we begin to sink. But what I like about Peter, well, Peter said, well, I might be sinking, but my Savior, the undefeated, undisputed champion of love, has not left me. So he cried out, Lord Jesus, please save me. I think he probably stretched his hand for Jesus to come and hold his hand. And Jesus, whether he was close to Peter or whether he was far, we don't know. But what we know is, wherever Jesus was, he was still close enough to save Peter. Let me tell you, our Jesus is not very far away from us. Remember the story of Lazarus. 4 days later, he was still on time. And at this time, Jesus stretched his hand and removed Peter from the doldrums of sinking. And he established his feet on top of the water. And Peter was with Jesus again because he cried out to the master to say, yes, this is what I can do. And Jesus and Peter walked together towards the boat. And they got inside the boat. Well, I would want to imagine what the disciples were talking about. But one thing that I know, that there is no impossibility with my Lord and Savior. You can walk on the waters of your life, the troubles of your life, if you allow Jesus, the undefeated, undisputed champion of love, to champion your life. Well, this is one of the most exciting stories. But I can't wait to tell you one more story. So tell your friends to join us again tomorrow as we listen to the most exciting, life-changing story of Jesus. God bless you.
Nika ino izere namo marwazo ne kuchema ziripo tinodana kuzitara Jesu iye achazo tinyaradza ukafamba naye pungua ze kuchema iwe iye wopuku Musatisi, Musatisi, Wotirite Gababa, Ateno Dawu, Hiro, when you,
Tika tipe izima ishe wangu tinodana kuzitara Jesu iye achazo tibatira ama yangu uya uya kuna Jesu iye achazo kunyarada ukafa Mungu wate kuchema Iye wopukuta Maso Titunga mire baba Titunga mire yuse Titunga tikwa nise
Peku wanda
Ruoko wenyu Ruoko wenyu Rutitunga mire rejezo
Baba, Musati siye, Tite da toparara, Tinoda wo, Hiro woko wenyu, Woko wenyu, Aguri tunga mirire,
Musati siye, Musati siye, Tite da Tinoda wa peku wanda, yeah, peku wanda, we muta, mutunga mire.
Mom.